do 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 do.
Hi.
That red hair is really looking familiar and very good on you.
Well, I'm not the only Jennifer in town.
Miss Peppermint.
Yes. Hello.
Hello, BenDeLaCreme and Miss Peppermint. Oh, Miss Peppermint, they're beautiful.
Oh, my goodness. Jennifer, we were going to introduce ourselves, but it seems our reputations precede us. We have all decided to dress today as one of your iconic characters. So we wanted to take a moment and see if you could guess who amongst us.
Let me see. Miss Peppermint. Okay, 13 going on 30.
Yes, Day.
Yes, Jackie Cox. We know who you are. Sydney Bristow.
Have you missed her?
I do miss her, actually.
You miss all her wigs?
You know, actually, in honor of yesterday, we did all have a five-year-old do our makeup this morning. So we have a few questions for you, if you don't mind us being so bold.
Do it. Yes, ready.
All right, I'm gonna kick things off, Miss Garner. So you've been a darling of the LGBTQ plus community for a long time, from kicking butt as Sydney Bristow, who's obviously a spy slash connoisseur of the wigs, and to being the ideal mom in Yes Day and Love, Simon. And so how does it feel to be a recipient of all that love back from our community? We love you.
It makes me wanna cry. I can't even tell you. When I met with Greg, it was just like, listen, I don't know if this movie can get made. If you would come and play this mom, it would be helpful. It was a time where it was kind of hard to leave home. And I just said, yeah, I have to. I mean, it's not even a question. Somebody asked me just recently the most important role I'd ever played, and I didn't even hesitate. I said, Love, Simon. To be out somewhere and have a kid come up and say, that helped me. That helped my mom and me. It helped my parents. I mean, it's like just the biggest, it's like, what more can art do besides help us through those moments? I'm just so grateful.
I know that love definitely goes all the way around. Why is it important for you? And honestly, maybe any actors considering what roles they may take and the connections that they have to the community, why is that connection to the LGBTQ community so important?
I mean, the connection to people is so important. The connection to opening up anything for people who are maligned or for people who are shut to the side or for people who are not given a fair shake. For me personally, I grew up in West Virginia, a very conservative state, as you guys know. I grew up entrenched in the gay community there. I was a ballet dancer and in the community theater. The guy that did my hair for years in that community theater, he was Miss Gay West Virginia. And I grew up like just revering both him and her. I knew them as two. Her talent, her beauty, her charisma, her shine. How lucky was I to just, you know, grow up in this state where you would think you wouldn't have that kind of just, I don't know, openness, but I did.
Now the hard-hitting question. If you were a drag queen, what would your drag name be?
Oh my gosh. What do you guys think? God, I feel like I've been a drag queen because I feel like Sydney was kind of a drag queen.
She's totally a drag queen.
You know what I mean? I feel like Electra was a little bit of a drag queen.
I have to say, I'm picturing you right now in like a fedora and a goatee, and I'm digging it already.
I'm gonna ask him for a date.
What about like a play on Sydney? What if it's like Melbourne Bristow?
I love it.
I think
or just like Melbourne. That's a good drag.
Melbourne.
Okay, so we have to talk about this because you know we're drag queens and you know we try to come out there with positivity as we know you do as well. But do you ever have to restrain yourself from giving that drag queen side eye or shade when people are getting on your nerves? How do you deal with the dark side of Jennifer? Like, does she come out sometimes?
She does, and I'm always, it's very hard for me when she has come out. I have to really forgive myself, but when people come at my kids too quickly or when they come at me when I'm clearly with my children and I just feel, it's definitely like,
It's not a yes day on those days.
It's not a yes day. And sometimes you're just not in the mood to be nice. You just aren't nice that day. And so whatever, I mean, it happens. It's not all sunshine and roses. I can give a side eye when I need to. Yep.
So you have definitely worked with hunky leading men in the past, and Edgar Ramirez is absolutely no exception.
He's so cute.
So what was it like working with Edgar?
Edgar is, it takes a minute to get past how beautiful he is.
Yeah.
I mean, I know that is so, maybe that's the wrong thing to say, but I'm just going to be honest with you guys. He's so handsome that you just
know.
Take a minute and just...
We really enjoyed the movie on many fronts.
He winked at one of the women that was working on the movie, and he just kind of is really casual about it and just gave her a little wink, like a hello. And she was like, oh my gosh, I think I'm pregnant. He's like, he just has that thing that you're just like, wow! He's more handsome because of how smart and dear and lovely he is. Too. So it's all around disgusting.
Now, if you were able to have a yes day with your kids, but it was reversed, what would be your three asks that your kids had to say yes to?
Ooh.
No arguing. They would have to like go for a hike with me because, you know, without complaint.
That's a yes.
That's a yes. And they would have to, what else would my kids have to do? They would have to just sit and be cozy with me and watch whatever I want to watch, you know, and like help me with dishes.
Cuddle up and watch some Netflix, Pat.
Alias Marathon.
That's right, kids.
So now let's continue your little yes day. This game is called Yass Queen or No Way Girl. If you have done one of these activities, you say Yass Queen, and if not, No Way Girl.
Okay.
So, are you prepared? Are you ready?
Yes.
All right. Us neither. All right. Have you ever been to a gay bar?
Yes, queen.
Yes, queen.
Have you ever been to a drag show?
Yes, queen.
How many drag shows have you been to in your life?
I don't know. 4 or 5?
Not enough.
Not enough?
Okay. Have you ever been in a drag show?
No, I haven't. I've never been invited onto the stage, but believe me, that is not something I would say no to.
This is a pressing question. Okay. That we all need the answer to. Have you ever kikied with Lady Gaga?
I don't know what kiki is.
This is what we're doing right now.
It's a kiki. Oh,
this is a kiki.
Just
a little kiki.
A party for calming all your nerves.
Gosh, with Lady Gaga, I mean, you know what? If we have blown kisses at each other from afar, so, you know, no way, gal. I think
that's a yes, queen.
Okay, yes, queen, yes, queen.
I think that's yes, queen.
Okay.
Speaking of queer icons, have you ever seen a Cher concert?
In real life?
In real life.
Sitting in the audience?
Sitting in the audience. Or, you know, or like, see, or have you blown a kiss at Cher from afar, like Gaga?
I mean, gosh, I'm sure I've
never performed
that. No way, girl. I don't think I have.
I haven't either. Don't feel bad. We still have time.
No way, girl.
She has a few more farewell tours left in her. We're gonna go.
Are you kidding? She's just getting started in the legend part of her career.
Yeah.
So let's move on to your personal skill sets. We know you can do the Thriller dance, but have you ever vogued?
Oh. Yes, queen. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
Yeah.
Can you give us a little bit right now if we give you a beat?
Sure.
A little.
Do it with me, though. I mean, we have to do it together. Yeah.
I think we got it.
I mean, yeah.
Stunning. Have you ever been to Fashion Week?
Yes, queen.
You have? And did you wear something like this?
I think I wore that exact thing, BenDeLaCreme. I've only been once, because believe it or not, I'm not a fashion icon. But I did go to, I think, Paris once for the Versace show, because Donatella made me a dress.
All right, so last question. Have you ever hung a poster of a pop icon on your wall at any point in your life, and who was it?
George Michael.
Mine was Davy Jones, so.
Oh, right, of course.
Mine was Janet Jackson.
Of course, yes.
Mine was Justin Timberlake. Like, it was before Britney, so it's okay.
Oh, wow. Oh, yeah, that's
okay. Oh, my gosh.
Well,
oh
Jennifer, God. We just want to thank you so much for taking this time to talk to us and hang out with us today. It was a lot of fun.
Oh my gosh, I couldn't love you ladies more. You are my yes day. Everyone can enjoy a day of yes. We all need it.
Yes, thank you, Jennifer. And also, we have to thank Netflix. So be sure to watch Yas Day on Netflix.
That's right. Grab your kids, grab your friends, grab your family. Tell everybody to have their very own yes day. You can share your photos and videos on socials using the Yes Day Challenge hashtag.